never been. I literally have never been to Comic-Con.
Last year?
No.
You covered it? No?
Nah. You thought I was there. I was not there. I was sick.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
Earlier
in the show, you guys were like, Jenny was there. I was like, no, I wasn't.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay, I love this first story. This could be the greatest delivery driver in the history of delivery drivers. One FedEx worker went beyond the job description to make a little girl's quarantine birthday extra sweet. This is Jordan Price of Fishers, Indiana. He's been a FedEx driver for 36 years, but this was his first time delivering to this particular address. So when he found out there was a birthday girl inside, he ran out and surprised little Emma with ice cream cupcakes for her and her family for her 6th birthday. Price said, hey, I know she wasn't in school because of the pandemic, so I just wanted to make this a special day. But here's the best part. The driver left so quickly, mom didn't get his name, so she posted on Twitter hoping to find him, and she did.
Mr. Price!
I was just gonna tell you, thank you for sitting there. I always tell my sons I always be nice and be.
There it is. Mom Liz flagged down several FedEx trucks on her street, literally chasing them. She's like, who is this mystery delivery worker? She tweeted the video. She tagged FedEx and Dairy Queen, and success. Mr. Price stopped by, and Emma, mom, and the family got to say thank you. So sweet. I love this story. The cast of The Office got together recently to help a couple tie the knot. Watch this and try not to have a little tear.
Ladies and gentlemen, the cast of The Office.
Oh my God. Oh my gosh.
It's you, and me, moving at the speed of light into eternity. Tonight is the night.
Join. John Krasinski officiated a virtual wedding for Susan and John on his web show, Some Good News. Krasinski, as you see, brought in the couple's closest friends on Zoom, had Jenna Fischer serve as honorary maid of honor, country singer Zac Brown serenaded them, and at the end, which is what you're seeing now, this made me so happy, he recruited all his old Office castmates to perform the show's spontaneous wedding dance. You probably remember that from their 6th season. By the way, the couple had a very similar proposal to Jim and Pam, which happened at a gas station. So sweet. And finally, if you know someone who still can't grasp the rules of social distancing, maybe this will help.
For those around you, please stand at least 1 meter apart. Thank you.
A four-legged canine-like robot called Spot has been unveiled in Singapore to remind park goers to keep 6 feet apart. So the robot is part of a 2-week trial run held by the National Parks Board. Spot was developed by Boston Dynamics. It's being deployed to, quote, reduce the manpower required for park patrols and just minimize contact among staff. It's got sensors and cameras, and that's supposed to help with the social distancing.
Oh, very cool. So, Jenny, the reason I asked you about Comic-Con is because we had a story that was supposed to be there right before you. They're going virtual. That's the thing.
Yeah. So that'll be my first year.
Hopefully, there you go.
I'll get to get there eventually.
Yeah, in the promo, they said you get to bring your pets to this one, right?
That's
awesome. Hey, little benefits.
So it'll be me and all the foster kitties watching.
No lines, no nothing. They released a virtual teaser, so can't wait to see how that's going to be. Jenny, thank you.
Well, there is nothing funny about this first story. A comedian started buying lunch for her sister's ICU unit, and now she's feeding thousands of people on the front lines.
We have fed over 3,000 healthcare professionals in the past 4 weeks, and this week alone, we fed 460 people at, again, 3 different hospitals.
New York-based stand-up comedian Katie Finn wanted to find a realistic way to help her sister, who's an ICU nurse, and other nurses. So she decided to buy him lunch one time, and then that's when she decided, hey, I'm going to start feeding our front lines. And that's the group she started. She put out a call to her friends, her family, her followers from the NYC comedy community to donate whatever they could so that she can continue to deliver food to frontline workers during the pandemic. Now, 6 weeks later, her organization has raised more than $34,000 and counting, while Finn continues to feed thousands of healthcare workers in hospitals throughout New York City and Connecticut. So props to her. Not being able to spend time with the people we love, it is really hard. And imagine how hard it is for little kids who may not grasp, they don't understand why they can't go in for that hug. Watch this.
If it's between crying.
I know, he's so overwhelmed. He's like, but why won't they hold me?
He was like going between crying and laughing. So that's 18-month-old Avery, and he misses his grandparents. So his mom, Ashley, who lives over in New Jersey, took Avery over to see her parents, who he hadn't seen in weeks. Obviously, they social distanced, but when Avery saw his grandparents, you can see he got so happy, but he's confused, right? He can't tell why they can't go in for a hug. Ashley, by the way, this is sad, really wanted Avery to see his grandparents because they recently lost her uncle to COVID-19, and she just wanted to bring a little joy and kind of some normalcy to Avery. And most of us really miss going out to dinner. So over in Amsterdam, a restaurant made little greenhouses so people can eat out while still social distancing. This may look familiar to you. It's something similar here in San Diego. This is a vegan restaurant by the water called Mediamatic Eaton over in Amsterdam. You sit inside one of the glass concept houses, which fits only about 2 to 3 people. And then they use these long wooden planks to serve so the wait staff can still maintain 6 feet of distance. Now, the glass house concept's still in a testing phase until it gets approved. But hey, this could be the look of eating going out forward.
You know, I don't mind it. No, it's actually really cute.
It's not bad. Yeah, it's romantic.
Yeah.
You know.
And then some people who are actually nervous being next to others that who are not in their family. This might work.
It's a built-in sneeze guard. If you sneeze, it just hits.
I'm telling you, that might be the new template. We might be seeing that a lot more. All right.
Thanks, Jenny. Thank you.